when we started Fusion on tour, we were throwing down all these dates, all these ideas, all these ways that we could share Jesus with the community around us, from the people that we see every day to maybe the people we should see every day. And one of the ideas that came up was to feed a homeless person, not to feed the homeless, but to feed a homeless person. Because I think one of the things God's really been revealing to me lately is that we kind of lose sight that they're made in the image of God too. So gave Avery a ring, said, hey man, what's something that we could mobilize maybe 15 to 20 people from Fusion to do? So he came up with this idea. We're going to go down to Woodruff Park downtown and just hand out some box Chick-fil-A breakfast to the homeless men and women who are down there. And so Saturday morning rolls around and there's 50 people in the parking lot up here at Fusion. And I'm like, wow, that's a lot of people who showed up. And so we kind of like just roll out in this convoy and go downtown, just grab our Chick-fil-A boxes and go to Woodruff Park. We go in and we were a little nervous, would homeless people be out there that soon? And let me tell you, they are. And if you haven't been downtown, if you haven't been on outreach like this before, you need to, because it's a wake-up call. It's a wake-up call that tonight when you are gonna be at home sleeping, they're still gonna be down there. Some of them on the street, some of them in shelter, some of them underneath overpasses. So we went down there again. It was that wake-up call that, man, the church needs to rise up and do something about this. And we need to go out there and be Jesus. Don't just leave it to the inner city churches to reach out to the people down there.
It will find you at the bottom of a bottle. It will find you at the needle's end. We'll find you when you beg and steal and borrow. It will follow you into a stranger's bed.
Most of the team kind of fanned out and they started doing prayer walks around the area, just really just kind of opening up their eyes both physically and spiritually to some of the stuff that's going on down there and just kind of taking the opportunity to pray.
We'll find you when they serve you with the paper.
That whenever we go down or whenever we minister to people who might be a little less fortunate to us, is there's a big difference between charity and pity. And charity is just realizing, man, they're made in the image of God too. We're called to be lovers of Jesus who share the love of God and who give freely. That's charity. But pity is, man, I feel so bad for you. Man, you're just so bad off. And now I'm better than you are. And so I can look down on you and have pity on you. Man, we're called to realize that we're all sons and daughters, that we're all children of someone, and that we're all made in the image of God. And we're called to go out into the world and share the love of Jesus. I just love it when we can take the opportunity, whether it be going to Discover Mills or the mall or in a hospital or going downtown and just telling people, hey, you're not forgotten, that God loves you. And whether it's through a hug, a prayer, or a box breakfast, to be able to say, man, God loves you and Jesus died for you too, and I'm here to remind you of that, and you are valuable.
Hang between two thieves in the darkness.
Outreach. I love it. If you didn't get a chance to come down, you really missed out, but we're going to be doing it again. So come on.
God, this would become a part of our heartbeat, a part of our life, that we would spend a portion of our life every day giving our time, giving of our resources,
yes.
Giving away,
yes.
God, so that others can be blessed with Jesus.